introduction to nano sensor and the silent features of nano sensor, the application area of nano sensor, and one example of nano sensor called as CNT, that is carbon nanotube, will be discussed.
Yes,
yeah. Sensor operating on scale of atoms and molecules. If somebody asks a question, just a question containing this much information, what are a nano sensor? Then you can give answer as simple as this. Nano sensor, a sensor operating on the scale of atoms or molecules can be called as nano sensor. Remember, nano sensors containing two things. One is the word NA, another one NO. NA, okay. I'm sorry for that. That discussion is a different one. Nano means 10 to the power minus 9. If the level of integration is 10 to the power minus 9 or little less or near to that, then it is called as nano sensor. If suppose you are doing implementation on VLSI, then you need to see the size of transistor used in order to make that implementation. It must be in the range of nanometer. Hope it is clear to everybody. I was keep on telling you while talking about the dimension of sensor. See, when the talk about dimension covers, then it should be with respect to VLSI implementation. In case of VLSI implementation, the smallest element in implementation is transistor. So we need to talk about the dimension of transistor. So its dimension is nothing but length into breadth. So if the length into breadth size of transistor is falling in the range of nanometer, then we call that implementation to be a nano implementation. If we are making a sensor for that, then it can be called as nano sensor. Nano sensor work in much way the same as of any other sensor, but the only difference is its size is small, right? Advantage, smaller size, lower weight, modest power requirement. We all know that the power requirement is directly proportional to the area of implementation. Remember this thing. If the semiconducting area is more, the more the power requirement. If semiconducting area is less, the less the power requirement. Therefore, if our implementation is smaller area implementation, lower weight implementation, that directly implies to less power requirement. Hope it is clear to everybody. There may be a chance that you will get a question, why nano sensor? In that case, this figure will be a motivating figure. Let us suppose that we want to sense the temperature of a bee body, right? Bee body, right? In that case, it's very, very small size of thermocouple need to be designed. So with normal implementation, it is not possible. We need to go to a very, very smaller scale implementation. So for that, a case study is given. Imagine needing to measure the temperature of individual living cell. That can be human cell, that can be a bee cell, whatever it may be. Suppose we want to measure the temperature of a cell, individual cell, right? So then, we all know that the size of cell is around 0.010 millimeter. So in order to do the measurement of temperature of that much small size, then the thermocouple wire would need to be smaller than a micron in diameter. That is next to possible. It is impossible, right? That's why we go for a special design of sensor, which is called as a nano sensor. Hope it is clear to everybody. I am going to an example of nano sensor called as carbon nanotube. Already you have discussed this thing maybe in physics or chemistry. This tube is particularly used for chemical sensing operation. It can also be called as carbon chemical nano sensor. Carbon nanotube is also be called as chemical nano sensor. Let us see what is this carbon nanotube. Carbon nanotube is actually cylindrical in shape, of dimension 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So they are cylindrical, made up of one or more. See, the roller can be single, the roller can be double, the roller can be three, four, based upon the requirement. That many rolls can be used. So carbon cylinders, they are made up of carbon cylinders of either one roll or multiple roll of graphene sheets. It is actually close off at either end by half sphere in shape of a soccer ball. This is about construction. Maybe I will not be able to give exact information about this, because this particular course is not doing the discussion of the construction of carbon nanosensor. So just for the coverage, I'm giving this information. You need to minimum remember that it is of shape cylinder having one roll or multiple roll of graphene sheets. What is important for an instrumentation engineer is how it works. That is very, very important, and that is very interesting also. So the principle of operation of carbon nanotube is very simple. Carbon nanotube based sensor work in this way. It work by monitoring electrical changes in sensor material. So this is actually the way in which we trap the information about the sensing by doing measurement of electrical changes of sensor material. So what changes sensor material doing, that is again important. See, the electronic property of carbon nanotube can change when the molecules or biomolecules are absorbed to their surface. Let us suppose that we actually wanted to extract the information from the surface. So for that, what we will do is we try to have an interaction of carbon nanotube with that surface. Because of the absorption to the surface, based upon its chemical nature, the conduction property of carbon nanotube get changes. Either it's increase the conduction or decrease the conduction. So these changes can be detected in terms of either resistance. We all know that the conduction can be detected in terms of change in resistance or change in capacitance, because change in inductance is a little difficult. So one can do the detection of these conduction with the help of a transistor also. An example of chemical surface. First, what I am doing is I am considering a case of nitrogen dioxide. When carbon nanotube contact with nitrogen dioxide, okay, then what happens is, when a molecule of this is present, it will strip an electron from the nanotube, which in turn causes the nanotube to be less conductive, meaning it lose the electron when it made contact with nitrogen dioxide. That is, its conduction get decreases when it is having more interaction with nitrogen dioxide kind of chemical surface. Consider the case of ammonia, NH3. If suppose CNT made a contact with ammonia, then what happen is, it react with water vapor and donate an electron to carbon nanotube, making it more conductive. So it means that when it is making contact with this type of chemical, then its conduction increases. So by measuring how much amount of conduction is getting increased, we can say that that much amount of contact being happen with the surface. Hope it is clear to everybody. Now I am moving to silent features. So this is already you people got it once from your physics course. Again, there is a chance that a short answer question may be expected on this. That's why this point again I am repeating. The silent feature of carbon nanotube is it is 100 times stronger than steel. I repeat, it is 100 times stronger in strength compared to steel. When talk about the weight, it is 1/6 that of steel. Okay, this is first point. This is explanation. If you want, you can write, or otherwise you can skip this thing. Under first point for silent feature, you need to write that it is 1000 times stronger than steel. when talked in terms of weight, it is 1/6 that of steel. Now about the conductivity, because we are in particular looking about two things. One is the weight and another one conductivity. Anyhow, the strength is an additional feature which we are getting from carbon nanotube. So when we talk about electrical conduction, so you see it is better conductor than the best conductor, that is copper. When we talk about the thermal conductivity, this is electrical conductivity. When we talk about thermal conductivity, its thermal conductivity is as high as diamond, right? So from the conduction point of view also, CND is the best source for the selection for the implementation of nanosensor. Now let us talk about, because we are making cylindrical shape of the implementation, so we need to talk, when we are talking about the dimension, we need to talk about the diameter. So the average diameter of carbon nanotube is 1.2 to 1.4 nanometer, that is 1 to unit 10,000 times smaller than the human hair. Hope it is clear to everybody. Three features you need to discuss under silent feature. One is the strength point, followed by the weight point with respect to steel. The second one is conductivity. The third point is the average diameter. The last thing, application. Basically, nano sensors are used for chemical sensing operation, or it can also be used for mechanical sensing operation. So a few are listed over here. Area point of view, you can write, it can be used in chemical sensing area, or it can also be used in mechanical sensing area. A few are listed over here. To detect various chemical in gases for pollution monitoring, for medical diagnostics purpose, either as blood-borne sensor or in lab-on-chip type devices. To monitor physical parameters such as temperature, displacement and flow, we can use nanosensors. It can also be used as accelerometer implementation for MEMS sensor, which can be used in our airbag system. We have covered discussion about carbon nanotube for nanosensors.